This is train number one, movement number two. You're looking at the run sheet for train number one, and you notice that we're using a paper clip to keep track of what movement we're doing. And so on this movement, we're going to go over to American Implement. We're going to drop off two loaded flat cars. And that's going to be on the other side of the layout. So train two has cleared the switch at the end of the siding, so train one can now depart. American Implement is a simple back-end drop-off, so we're going to bring the whole train into the siding and drop off the two loaded flat cars. We're stopping short of the siding because we have to drop the loaded here. There are two empty flat cars at the location that we have to pull out first. We disconnect the two loaded flat cars from the rest of the train and they're ready to deliver. Now notice on the loading dock, this rusted metal plate right here, that's hinged along this end, and once the car is tied down and the brakes locked, this metal plate folds forward, and that's how they roll the cars or the tractors off the cars. We've dropped the two empty cars here, so another train will come and pick them up at a later time. Now we can reconnect our train. Now we're going to run train one through this siding and onto the siding that bypasses the yard. We're going to head back out onto the main and head to the yard bypass track. Train 1 is now clear of the yard lead, and train 2, when it's completed its switching, will come through the yard bypassing the siding and train 1. This is how we pass on this end of the layout. So ends train 1, movement 2.